What is up? It's Mikey, and we got another GTA Online update, the hipster update, and lots of cool new features, so let's just get into it. So one of the big features that they finally added, only took them 9 months, head over to the back of your garage, and right there you can access vehicle management. And you'll notice that when you highlight a vehicle, pushing up and down, you notice that there's an arrow moving, and that will show you where you can place the vehicle, and you can rearrange them in just the way you want. And speaking of vehicles, they did add 6 brand new vehicles. They're pretty pricey considering how old they look, but one of the cool vehicles is a Benefactor Panto. Really small and a whole lot of mods. Really fun to play with. It's actually small enough to fit in some of the stores. You can go racing around in there and have some fun. They also added some vehicles that were kind of sort of rare. The BF Surfer, which is the clean Volkswagen. The Bravado Yuga. The Yuga has a lot of mods to it, that van right there. They also added the Buffalo S. Previously, you used to have to mod that into the game. And the Obey Tailgater. That's Michael's car. That was kind of sort of rare. And so in addition to Franklin and Michael's cars, yes, you can get Trevor's Hot Rod Blazer. And of course, it's $69,000. Another new vehicle heading over to the Warstock website. The Dubsta 6x6, it holds 6 players. It's 249k, but it's actually pretty rough and tough. It's got some decent speed, pretty good handling. Keeping up with vehicles here, they added 2 new paint jobs, pure gold for 50 grand and brush gold for $45,000. Really cool paint jobs if you're tired of chrome. Moving on, if you head over to Windows, you can actually have a pure black tint for 10 grand. And just like it says, it's pretty much pure black. It's almost impossible to see inside. And we have new tire smoke. We have brown and pink, and the pink is actually very, very pink. It's pretty bright. So very cool new colors. And as always, all of these vehicles are free in story mode. All you gotta do is go into your garage, and from there you can hit the menu and select whatever vehicle you wanna play with. Also, under horns, we have some new jazz horns, but there's a horn called a jazz horn loop. It's 50 grand. Yeah, it's pretty pricey, but this has a cool feature where depending on how fast you drive, that's how fast the horn is gonna loop. So that's pretty cool. Here's a little sample right here. So yeah, I did try going in reverse. No, the horn will not play in reverse, but it's still pretty cool. Now, of course, new clothing. Real quick, if you want to check out some of the outfits, just go up to the cashier, go to outfits, hipster, and you can see a couple different wardrobes. Not exactly cheap, but not too expensive. Seems to hover around like 5 grand average. Pretty cool clothes. Not my style though, so. They added some scarves and some other things, so make sure to check that out. For you guys, they got some new beards. Oh, actually, quite a few of them. Kind of expensive for a beard, but it's about like, they'll range from 2 to 5 grand. And there's a couple hairstyles in there for you, hipster styles. We got some new emotes. We have the air guitar, as it describes, you're playing an air guitar. We have the wave, sort of looks like a parade float wave. If you want to surrender to somebody, you can do that with the surrender emote. Someone's being too loud, go ahead and use the shush. And if you see something you like, go ahead and use the photography emote. Probably one of my favorites, the DJ. Messing with the ones and twos, got your hand on your headset. And we've got Airson playing an electronic piano, pretty much. And for all you furries out there, we've got a lot of new masks. You can be a raccoon, owl, a fox, and yes, even a kitty. And actually, these are kind of pricey, ranging from 21,000 to 25,000 bucks. And what would a hipster be without their tattoos? Lots of tattoos. Some of them are actually pretty hard to find. I was looking forever trying to figure out where the hell is this mustache tattoo. And it actually ended up being on this guy's bicep. Some of them are actually really small. They're on the wrist. So you may have to look a little hard to find them. Not really worth it in my opinion, but hey, that's just me. So these are just some of the major things you will notice. They did a lot of bug fixes. They added a lot of new little things. So make sure you read the description down below to see the full list of details. By the way, I'm still giving away a copy of GTA Online for next gen PS4, PC, and Xbone. I have a link to that down below. If you want to play with me, send me questions, Twitter, Facebook, best way for that. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video, and I'll see you next time. And I got this nice, fun, aggressive setup here for domination. Yeah, I got the Vector. I've been messing around with it lately. It's pretty fun. You know, just been trying to have fun with Call of Duty Ghosts. The thing I like and I hate about Ghosts Did you die so damn easy? I want you to watch my devs how it seems like I die in like one or two bullets. I know a lot of people don't like that. That's why we got more people on Black Ops 2. You know, when you get hit, you know how it is. You can run around a corner. In this game, once you're hit, it's pretty much game over. So for that reason, though, it does...